will introduce themselves.
I'm Rekha. I'm working as a Scrum Master for Polaris.
Hi, my name is Nizam. I work for a company called Red Team.
I'm Sandeep. I'm Senior Manager for Product.
And I forgot to tell where I'm working. I work in a company called Gainsight, which is a startup company. And coming to current trends, we will take turns explaining our points, and because when it comes from the people who started the idea, it will come better. So we will take turns explaining the points that came across. One thing that we started with the report was that software is just one among the 14 plus industries that are using Scrum. But if you see, all of us approximately belong to software industry, right? But the report says that software is just one among the 14 plus industries that are using Scrum. So there is a lot of things that we are missing by not including other people, not participating in this kind of conferences. Hopefully it will happen soon in the future with us. And one more thing which I found what interesting was that the survey respondents changed projects once in every 3 months. It says that there are approximately 4 projects that everybody got involved in. Not everybody, most of the people got involved in over a period of years. Which means that average project, they change projects every 3 months. That's a lot of change in my personal opinion. I work for a product company, and I don't understand the meaning project yet completely. What classifies or what qualifies as a product? So that is something that was interesting to me. And other people can also talk about.
One of the major trends that I see is people, when we are transitioning from waterfall to agile, any agile, the first thing that we do is to bring in the ceremonies. The first thing, okay, I'm doing Scrum, so I'll start doing a daily Scrum, I'll start doing sprint planning. But unfortunately, people don't realize there is a question called the why before what and how, which is more important than what and how. People are forgetting that concepts. People don't realize that why, don't understand why we have to transition from agile to waterfall to agile, and they start doing agile. They're not being agile, but they're doing agile, which is not the right way of doing it. That's one of the trends. Okay, how are you transitioning? Okay, we started with daily scrum, we started with planning, we started with product backlog grooming, but why are you doing it? Oh, it's actually prescribed. But why that prescription nobody really understands. I see that is the current trend. In future trends, probably when they are coaching, even in the certifications, I'm CSM, even in the certifications, I didn't do my CSM from Eisenbridge or something. But when I did, they immediately start with, okay, what are the Scrum ceremonies that we have, what are the rules, what are the artifacts. But why this? Why should we change? That question, if it is answered, people would internally start realizing, yes, I need to do this, yes, I need to do this. The teams would become much more mature, and then they be agile or rather do agile. That's the current trend, and I wish that's the future trend.
You mean to say that the majority of the team who are using agile are doing ceremonies in written pieces?
No, they're doing ceremonies as prescribed in Scrum Guide. But why are we doing it? Why? What is the value that we are getting by doing the daily Scrum? What is the value that I'm getting by doing the retrospective? Retrospective is done for the sake of retrospective, yeah. What are the action points? Yes, noted down. What are the improvements that we are doing? Noted down. But why are we doing it? What is the value that we are getting out of it? It is not something that is really going into the minds of everybody who is doing.
So culture and mindset change.
That should happen. It's not yet happening. That's the current trend. That should happen in future trend is what I see.
What I see is that, the discipline of the team. You understand, why should I be there at all the time on 10 o'clock, man? That's the kind of attitude. Because they don't understand the importance of stand-up. So if they don't understand, the whole thing doesn't make any sense. It starts with the stand-up meeting. They don't have a problem. Probably we are not going
there.
That discipline has to come up in the team.
Yeah. Rather than emphasizing on the framework, ceremonies, artifacts, I think the values, principles, the agile manifesto should be given higher priority, at least in future, rather than these artifacts, rules, and ceremonies.
I have a question. Why question should be asked? I'm going to implement a project and why should I implement that in Agile way only? Okay, that why question should be asked, because my organization has mandated it should be implemented in RFP. It is mentioned we are doing it as per the, you know, Agile scrum, blah blah blah, and the team is dumped. Our team might not be knowing what the Agile is. If you ask a team member, do you know what is Agile?
Yes.
You will get different answers. Okay, so those questions, you know, the team might have, organization might have taken, think that we'll execute the project in the Agile way. That is one question, that why question should be asked before the management.
I'm not saying that.
No, I'm just adding that. That will be more priority there. You are concentrating on the artifacts, ceremonies, right? Why we are doing that. That why question will be anyways answered if you are well versed of the Agile principles. If you are well versed of the Agile principles, why are we doing these ceremonies, why are these artifacts, this documentation or whatever the learnings or trainings is happening, with that team will be aware, like, why are we doing this? General awareness and
problem. So that's what I said. So if they are actually well versed with manifesto, values and principles,
then, yes.
Then the why question is answered.
Yes.
So.
Great, last 4 minutes.
I think the next point I want to make is very interesting. Is when we go to sales, when we go to customers, they are loving people who come with Agile experience, who talk about Agile terminology. So I see that adoption coming very, very well. When you go and say my schedule is 18 months, because the sales are normally kicking you off. But when you say, hey, I can give you something in 4 months, 6 months, they are loving you and say, hey, I want this guy off my project. So that's a major trend which I see, that people coming from traditional backgrounds who are still sticking to waterfall and not going into scrum or not getting the best of two worlds, they are left behind. And people who are coming with this agile knowledge are somebody who are more recognized, who are able to solve sales problem, and if you solve sales problem, you are loved into the organization. So that's one trend I have seen. As a trend, probably I will make a point after he completes.
To add this point, I think most of the conflicts in the between a development team which is following scrum and the operations of business team which don't know scrum. So the operations team is most used to, like, I want this problem to be solved right now. Now she goes to the product manager and say, hey, I want this problem to be solved right now. Product manager will say, okay, I'll buy this. Now, what does that mean? So that conflict is the current trend, and I think it'll be the future trend as well. That conflict will happen from time to time every organization. I think startups might be at advantageous side, because right from inception everyone might be pushed on scrum and say, hey, what is this, right from the beginning. But for larger organizations, I think this challenge will be going on from time to time. I don't think there'll be any time soon.
We have 2 minutes
of
questions.
I'll add one point to the future trends. Scrum, we have seen there are certain things that are prescribed in the Scrum Guide or that are recommended in the Scrum Guide. But in future, probably it will not be Scrum anymore. So it will be a hybrid model, which is having practices from other models, maybe XP. We already have it, but it will be much more in place than what it is now. Because now we are trying to adapt to Scrum. In future, we'll be adapting to the hybrid models that are coming up. We will be hearing lots and lots more in future. That's one of the future trends that I see.
And to add to this point, initially what you said, right now most of us are from software or product development. But eventually Scrum or Agile will be more included to other areas of the organization. So like HR. HR can also adopt Agile methodology.
Yeah. Education system. Your colleges might start doing it. You might deliver, one unit is in one sprint, the other unit another sprint. So that's what I make my child do. I will study for her exams in the way of Scrum. I put her backlog and then I make her do a planning, deliver.
Yeah, I think one point with respect to top management, because report says that a lot of people are adopting Scrum, there's a lot of support from top management. My on field experience is, it has maybe only gone into 10 to 15% into their heads. Or they want to use it only to their convenience. Okay? They want to see, okay, if you cannot do this, you're not an agile guy, your team is not an agile team. So I think as an industry, they have to focus on how this top-down approach goes more in an intrinsic way. Today they use it more for extensive way, okay, how do I get my project to sell faster? How do I sell a better schedule than probably what Chinese are selling? So they use it to their own advantage. Not really to have the benefit of improving the quality of the product, or really having the benefit of being a sustainable team. Not really to have a culture of proper work-life balance. So that is not yet visible. I don't know when it will be visible. Maybe we will be all retiring by that time.
There is a point in the report which supports what he says, which is only 12% of the respondents said that the actual Scrum team is included in the estimation. So probably that is related.